Hey guys, I'm back with a new video today. Another depressed video from the depressed and burned out YouTuber. You know, maybe I should start these videos different. Maybe I should bring more hype to my voice. Maybe. Hey guys, what's going on? Today I'm back with another video. We're gonna talk about the Dark Zone today. Does that sound like I'm very hyped about the game? I just want you to know that I'm fine, you know? That I don't have depression. Or that I'm not burned out. I just want to have a normal conversation without having to scream into the mic. If that makes any sense. But yeah. On a more serious note, I have one last video that I want to share. Which is this one. Which is basically my feedback video. The good, the bad, and also the things that really caught me by surprise. Sort of the notes that I made throughout playing and the things that I would tell the developers if I were to have a straight up conversation with them. So yeah, the intro of this video was already a little bit too long because of the excitement. But yeah, let's start right away. Starting with the good, the things that I really like about the game, which first up is the gunplay. Now, when I posted the gameplay that I recorded at Massive Studios a few months ago, one of the first things that I mentioned in that video is that I really liked the way that the guns felt, the way that they sound, and just the feedback that you get from them. It's a combination of the sound and the visuals, and also just the hit markers when you land shots. I don't know. It all felt really good to use back then on console, and now on PC it also feels really good. Aiming is 100% snappy, at least with the mouse and keyboard. The shots that you fire feel impactful due to the lower time to kill, both in the early game PvE and in the PvP. And I do really feel that I want to use different weapon classes now when I fight at different ranges. I still stand by the point that I think snipers and shotguns shouldn't stagger players in PvP. And also that the forced first-person scoping, I think it's still super clunky, especially with the lack of a dedicated scoped sensitivity slider. Now, I have seen a lot of comments that said to me that, well, what do you think happens in real life when you get hit by a 50 caliber shot, Marco? But yeah. I don't really care what happens in real life. We're talking about a game here, and we're talking about a game where realism has been thrown out of the window and left behind a long, long time ago, where we have magical healing clouds and where enemies take 20 bullets to the head anyway. So I don't really care about realism, I just care to have a fun experience. And I don't think that the stagger on the shotguns and the snipers is fun. The developers did say, though, that it will be removed for the final game, so that's why I'm not going to go too much more into that. But yeah, the forced first-person scoping, I'm still not a fan of it. It still feels very clunky, and I ended up using the sniper weapons without their scope just because I didn't want to go into the first person. Now, another thing that I really liked about the game are the endgame character builds. I already went in-depth about the character builds and the RPG mechanics in a previous video, but damn, just looking at it again, at the level 30 characters, I can see there's a lot of options for a lot of variety, and it's still such a small slice that we got to see. We still haven't seen gear sets yet, we still haven't seen exotic weapons yet. So yeah, this is the part about the game that I'm personally most looking forward to. I mean, just look at this for example. I can have the same gear talent on both my chest and my backpack, which means we can possibly stack 6 of the same type of talents for some insane specialized builds. Or look at this chest piece again with 3 mod slots and then so many stats on it. Looking at all the different endgame characters that we got to use in the beta. Yeah, I think the difference between two players is going to be pretty significant. And this is, again, the part that I like the most about the game so far. And that says a lot if you keep in mind that just 6 months ago with the E3 reveal, the character build variety was something that I was really worried about. This was it was basically my biggest concern back then. So seeing how much this all has been improved, yeah, I'm really happy with it. Now, something that I was also very pleasantly surprised by is how feature-rich some of the aspects are of the game this time around. Let me just quickly talk about Skirmish, for example. You think Skirmish is just a PvP game mode, right? That you kind of just play off to the side when you just want to do some quick PvP? Oh yeah, it is. But also, look at all the stats that are being tracked in Skirmish in-game. Your kills, your deaths, your assists, your skill kills, you can see your damage, all that stuff. All these things are being tracked, so to speak, just for this side mode. And this is the type of stuff that I wished we had in the Division 1, because it just it just screams that, yeah, they put a lot of work in it and they really thought about, well, what do players want from the game modes? It just shows they went above and beyond to add more and more features on top of everything to try and make the game better. You see it here, but you also see it everywhere else, like also the smaller things. For example, we don't have to restock anymore when we go into a checkpoint, into a Dark Zone checkpoint. There's a perk that you have to unlock at the base of operations. And once you have that perk, you can just go into the Dark Zone checkpoint and then go back out without having to go to a restock box, and you will still restock all your armor plates and all your grenades. So it's the little things, it's the extra features that make this game more complete, in my opinion. And just to put it together, because I really want to try to keep the video under 20 minutes this time. Yeah, the gunplay feels good, the RPG mechanics, the character building seems deep and rich, and the game looks to be feature-rich and polished around most of its corners. At least that's the intent. But then, you know, it's a beta and the game definitely isn't perfect. So now I want to talk about what I didn't like about the game, what I think still needs a lot of work, because there's just so much stuff that just, you know, doesn't work properly yet. And I know this is an opinion that not everybody shares. I mean, some people do, but not everybody. But I think that the character movement and the abilities and the skills in general, it all feels very, very sluggish as opposed to the gunplay, which was very tight. It's actually such a stark contrast. You know, when you aim down sights, it's near instant. And you shoot, it's instant. The gunplay feels good. It's snappy. But then trying to place skills on the floor, it goes so slow. Throwing your skills in the air, it's so slow. And with the faster time to kill, especially in PvP, it starts to feel very sluggish. I think we already went over this with the Division 1, though, because in the Division 1, we learned that having long animations for things such as the skills isn't a great thing. Just think about the healing delay that everybody always talked about. You know, when the Division just came out, you pressed your first aid and then you wouldn't get healed up until like a second later after the animation. Now, a second isn't that long, but still, people complained about it a lot. And because the time to kill is shorter, it feels like even longer. It basically means that you end up always pressing your skills before a fight starts. There's nothing that you can really activate mid-fight, so to speak. And then after your skills are deployed, that's when you start shooting. So, as I said in my previous video, when I talked about the PvP, how it's kind of boring, you press your skills, you aim down sights, and you shoot at each other. That's basically what it comes down to. That's the whole flow of combat in this game. And then, of course, there's also the topic that the Seeker Mine is just way too strong. It has the one-shot potential again. But on the other side, the Seeker Mine also doesn't function properly half of the time. So I guess you could say that balances each other out, right? But yeah, no, I think this is two things that they really have to look at. So yeah, skills and movement aside, the second thing that I also wasn't really a big fan of is the user interface. And I'm not the only one bringing this up. I've seen many, many people talk about this already, but man, the user interface is bad, especially on PC. There are just so many buttons that you should be able to click with a mouse, but then you can't click with the mouse because they're grayed out or because the game simply doesn't allow you to click them with the mouse. There's a lot of double clicking involved in the menus to navigate. And there's also, there's just more to it. Like deconstructing trash gear is also less than convenient, I should say, because you have to go through an extra menu to actually deconstruct all your trash. And then things such as the sealed caches, they not only take a long time to open again, but after you open them, after you hold the button for 3 seconds, the game then also asks you again if you are sure you want to open the box. Because yeah, holding down the button for 3 seconds was definitely something that somebody would do on accident. It's just, why? Why do this? Why can't you just make the caches open near instantly? It's these little things that are just everywhere in the UI that just don't make any sense to me. You know, you completed the mission. Are you sure you want the loot? Nah, just leave it in the cache, bro. I don't need that shit. I'm not playing this game for loot. Also, the whole UI seems to suffer from a very bad RGB split effect that happens when you navigate menus, open menus, when you look at the scoreboard in Skirmish. And it is even something that just randomly appears every 5 or 10 seconds or so when you're manhunt. Just every 5 or 10 seconds, your screen starts to blur out a bit and split up. It's the crosshair, it's the group UI, it's everything, and it's really, really annoying. It really distracts you from the gameplay. I'm not sure if this is done because the developers thought it would look cool or because they wanted to give yet another disadvantage to the manhunts, which, if you want to give the manhunts another disadvantage, don't do this, do something else, because this just, it's not really a disadvantage. I wouldn't say that the performance of players will suffer with this effect. People can get used to it. It is just super, super annoying. And turning off chromatic aberration in the graphic settings, which I think is what this effect is officially called, doesn't disable any of this. So I don't know what's going on. But yeah, while we're on the topic of the Dark Zone, also a little bit specific, but I also want to talk about the Dark Zone turrets. Now, I don't think that the Dark Zone turrets, the design of them, are great. I'll get back to that in just a second. But let's imagine that we all agreed that the turrets were pretty cool. Well, if you die as a manhunt, and your teammates are still alive, and you respawn, and then you go back into the Dark Zone from the checkpoint, well, guess what? You are, a lot of the times, flagged up again as a manhunt or a rogue. And thus, the moment that you step out of the checkpoint, the turrets are gonna kill you. This basically means that you can't get back into the fight after you died. You cannot get back into the Dark Zone unless your whole group is dead or unless you leave group. I mean, that's a pretty big oversight, right? And I hope something can be done about this as well. And I know this is probably one of those buggy things that, you know, is in the game because it's a beta. You'll probably say it gets fixed. And in this instance with the turrets, I can agree. This is probably gonna get changed before launch. There's no way they're not gonna change it. But on the topic of bugs and glitches, I'll just say it once more, but I don't think they're going to be able to patch this game up before release. And I'm not just talking about the small things. There are core gameplay mechanics, core things of how this game works mechanically that are just broken. Like, for example, like I mentioned in January when I came back from Massive Studios, head glitching is still a thing in this game. You can shoot people from around corners if you angle yourself the right way. This was an issue in Division 1. I've talked about this many, many times on my channel, and it is still an issue in this game. Nothing's changed. Nothing at all. So if the developers were gonna fix this, it would have already been done, right? I guess, because this was a well-known issue. But it's still here, and in fact, you can just get shot by players that are simply still behind cover on your screen. Just look at this instance. Even the game itself thinks that the player I'm shooting here, the game thinks that this guy is out of combat because he can't see me because I'm head glitching. It instantly refills the player's armor, the guy that I'm shooting at. I shoot him with my sniper and it refills his armor because the game thinks that this guy is out of combat. That's how bad this is. The player cannot see me shoot at him. I'm shooting him from behind cover. That's called a head glitch, and that's still in the game, and I don't think it's gonna get fixed.
That's not a thing that's gonna be working.
There's a player.
Instead of us being in front of the checkpoint, we just camp the area where they can go out.
Come on. Have balls. Have balls. This guy does have his no ball. Hey! What the f- Look at that shit! Look! Vital signs critical.
Instead the baby rage though. I like it.
Oh, do you have one shot?
Oh, there's a guy.
He's low.
Is he a left?
Have I sniped him? Nearly dropped their full armor.
What? He's head glitching as well. Like, look at that. You can only see his arm. Like, look at that. He's just shooting.
I can't see.
Yeah, you can. I told you this was still in the game as well. It's like, how could they not fix that shit? They knew it's an issue in Division 1. They built a division from the ground up. It's still an issue in Division 2. Explain, right? Explain. How did that happen? So yeah, it's just things like this shouldn't be in a game with PvP. You can do this against NPCs as well, you know, as I showed in one of my other videos. But I said in my previous video that we'll talk about this. What date did I say? The 28th of March. I think I said 28th of March, about 2 weeks after launch. We'll talk about the Division then and its technical state and see if all these bugs, glitches, exploits, and core issues, let's see if they're in the game or not. If they're not, then I guess I'll take back everything I ever said and I'll start to look at betas for games in a very, very different way. But I don't think it's gonna happen, guys. I just don't think it's gonna happen. But yeah, this is a beta feedback video, I guess. So it's expected to have bugs. So for now, ignoring all the issues the game still has, let's pretend the game doesn't have any bugs or exploits or all that stuff. there's also something else I really want to talk about, which I already kind of touched upon in my previous video, but it's about the PvP. You know, this game has PvP, but with the Division 2, the way it's set up right now, it doesn't really feel like a PvP game anymore. So let's start off with the Dark Zone. You know, going into the Dark Zone, I found that it was really hard to find some other players that I could just kill. Simply because I couldn't find a lot of players. Maybe this is because the pull skill isn't in the game yet, but I found fights very few and far in between, and when I found them, they only lasted like a couple seconds. Half of the players in the Dark Zone actively avoid fights as well, either sitting next to the checkpoint turrets until you leave, or simply going into the checkpoint and then not coming back out after dying one or two times. And maybe it's because we also have a lot of new players checking out the game right now, or maybe because you can't see rogues as clear on the map or as clear on your screen anymore as before, so players tend to not go to rogue players. But right now, at least in the beta, if you went into the Dark Zone just to PvP, just to play PvP, well, you were going to be bored. You were just going to be very bored. And then, of course, the counter argument would be to say, well, just play Skirmish if you want to play the PvP. The Dark Zone isn't meant for just straight up PvP. And you've got a point there, but if you're a pre-made team of four, all sweaty, all tryhard, you know, because this game is your shit. You want to play this game as much as you can, and you want to try out how hard you and your squad can go. If you're that sort of player, every Skirmish game is going to feel like a free win, even with the skill-based matchmaking. You know, it got to the point where me and my friends, we got so bored that we started playing hide and seek with the enemies within the Skirmish map, basically after we killed all of them and they were on their last two lives, so to speak. We just started hiding and seeing how long it would take them to find us. And then when they would find us, we would kill them with just melee attacks, just to entertain the stream a little bit and to entertain ourselves, because really, Skirmish is nothing more than a pub stomp. And sure, I might meet another super sweaty four-man squad one day, maybe when I'm streaming, that have enough of my cocky face and they just want to stream snipe me, and then, you know, then the match might be different. It might be more exciting, it might be more fun, but for the most part, yeah, I don't know, Skirmish is kind of boring. So then, when you're at that point, what do you do after Skirmish? What's the next thing that you will look for in this game to try to make the PvP more exciting? Well, obviously, you're going to go into the Dark Zone. But the Dark Zone isn't set up for that type of PvP anymore. You just don't get those fights anymore. You don't get the 4v8s. There's never 8 players to fight. And if there are, you're probably going to die, let's be honest, because the time to kill is super short. There's one-shot snipers. It only takes one bullet of a random guy just chilling in the back, and your manhunt's over because you can't come back because the turrets will insta-kill you as soon as you try to go back in. It's just a mess. It's not set up for PvP in that same way anymore. And it's just a little sad. And also, don't think that the turrets are too good, because spawn camping is still very much possible, you know? The turrets, they add a whole lot of trouble, but they don't prevent the spawn camping, because people can just sit a bit further back, right where the checkpoint turrets cannot kill you, and then the moment the players run out of that spot, then you can just kill them anyway. So it doesn't really do anything, especially because snipers are one-shot. You can just snipe players from a distance as they come out of the checkpoint. And also, there's still a safe house in the middle of the map, and that one doesn't have turrets. And you can still spawn camp players right there, just like in the Division 1. It's just so many mechanics in this game. They've added all of them to try and make the game more fair, but as a result, the game is still just as unbalanced in a lot of ways. It's just less fun. It's just less fun. It just doesn't work, in my opinion. I do, however, recognize that this is more of a personal complaint, and this doesn't really apply to the more casual audience, maybe. You know, those guys who go into the DZ and, with big quotation marks, are not sure what's going to happen. It's a scary, scary place. For those people, the DZ might be more appealing, but for any hardcore PvP player trying to get any consistent PvP experience out of the Dark Zone, it's just not there anymore. The game, it has PvP, but it's just that. It's just PvP, and it's more frustrating than fun. Also, 60 seconds to wait when you die as a manhunt. Really, guys. Now, if you're watching this video and all my complaints sound like music to your ears, because finally, you will not get ganked as often anymore by the rogue bullies, then I say, good for you. You might actually enjoy this game. This game is probably gonna be fun for you. And no hard feelings, you know? I'm happy for you. I'm happy that you'll probably finally get the game that you've been waiting for. But it also means that myself, I'm probably just no longer the target audience for this game. So, I'm not saying that nothing can be done to fix the game and it's all doom and gloom. I'm not saying that. I'm also not even saying that anything should be changed. I don't know if things should be changed. I don't think so, because maybe this way, with how the game is right now, it's gonna be more fun for more people. I'm just saying that from my perspective, I cannot see myself playing this for very long after launch, if it indeed stays like this. And that's a pretty painful thing to say for me, because I've been waiting for this game for so long. I'm a big Division fan, but when it's just, when so many core mechanics are just not working properly, and yes, I know it's a beta, yes, I know it's a beta, and when so many, when the gameplay is just not entertaining to me, then what can you do? But yeah, that's going to wrap up this video. That's all I'll say about the beta for now. Overall, I still think it's a big step up over the first game in many ways. It's more feature-rich, we have interesting gear, it's bigger than before. But at the same time, some of the things that I personally really liked about the first game, the things that really kept me playing, most of them seem to be gone now, and I don't know if I like the improvements enough to compensate for what's gone. So yeah, as always, I'll see you guys later, or like they say in the Netherlands, zie je later.